genetic engineering is ethical. Before we begin though, I would strongly suggest that you go and check out my previous video on the human genome and genetics, as watching that will make this video easier to understand. So, genetic engineering, first of all, is taking an object's DNA replacing it with better DNA so that you can make a better organism in total. One main part of genetic engineering is the modification of your actual DNA. Like, take something like shown in this picture. You have a strand of DNA, and you have this little piece here that's responsible for how smart you are and how good eyesight you have. Now, what genetic modification does is take these little pieces, find another piece that's better than what you have, and replace them so that you become smarter and have really good vision. You can also learn more about how exactly genetic evolution works along with modification by the study of bacteria that have survived an attack by things known as bacteriophages. Bacteriophages are like killer missiles that will target a bacteria and destroy it. More will be talked about this in one of my future slides. So, using some of the current qualities of things like the current GMOs, which are very controversial, I'm aware, but using things such as GMOs and a new topic known as CRISPR, which basically means clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats. That is a very fancy word for meaning that you can take bad DNA and replace it with good DNA. Topics such as CRISPR and genetic modification are actually very, very new, but they can be very helpful in the long run. So how would genetic modification work? Take something like this. You have a regular fruit that's not resistant to insects. After this, you have a piece of bacteria that has a genetic that makes it resistant to insects. You take the DNA, make a copy of it, and breed it with the regular fruit. And then after this, you get the insect-resistant fruit. So the new strategy is called CRISPR, like I mentioned earlier, and it's a powerful tool that works with the hormone known as Cas9. Cas9 is a hormone that bacteria that have survived an attack by phages have. What that hormone does is it constantly reviews the DNA of the bacteria, and if it ever finds something out of the ordinary that isn't the actual normal bacterial DNA, it will instantly destroy it. This can be a very powerful tool in humanity's fight against sewer bugs and diseases such as AIDS, cancer, and HIV. These diseases work by having cells that don't die by themselves and cells that hide from your immune system. What Cas9 will do is it will give your immune cells, just imagine it as a night vision goggle, so that they can find all the cancer and all the other bad cells that are hiding in your body. So, how does genetic modification work? There's more parts to it. So, one example, scientists found an object that always constantly removed bad things, such as benzene and chloroform, from the air. They took that thing's properties and infused it with a plant using genetic modification and genetic engineering. And what they had afterwards is a plant that if you put it in your house, there will never be anything such as chloroform or benzene in the air, because that plant will consistently suck that in without being affected by it. So when the phages that I mentioned earlier attack the bacteria, how they work is they basically have an icosahedron head. They have a long, thin, really thin neck. Then they have like an abdomen with a bunch of legs. So they have the giant bacteria. They go and sit in the bacteria. And basically what they do is out of their abdomen, a spike shoots out that penetrates the bacteria's outer shell. And after that, what the phage does is it takes the DNA stored in its icosahedron head and pumps it into the bacteria. The bacteria have no strong defense against it. And afterwards, the DNA from the phage converts the bacteria into a factory for more phages. phages are done multiplying inside the bacteria, they will release an enzyme that will, think about it like this. You have a little missile that goes inside of a big ship. It doesn't explode. It multiplies into a bunch of other missiles, and then they simultaneously all explode. And think about what happens to the ship afterwards. That's, you have an idea of what happens to the bacteria after a phage attack. So what is a bacteriophage? So I mentioned their techniques of penetrating and destroying a bacteria, also how they reproduce. But what exactly is it? So like I mentioned here, they have the icosahedron head, which is a shape with 20 faces and 30 edges. They have the body, they have the abdomen, and they have the spindly little legs. Once they alight on top of the bacteria's plasma membrane, they will shoot out this little spike, which will go in, that will be known as a core, and phage DNA will come out from here. And after this, think about all the DNA and all the raw materials inside of the bacteria just combine and form like a trillion more phages, and then all of a sudden, the entire thing explodes. And all those phages are released to do the cycle all over again. So why are phages so important in today's world? Basically, humans messed up a lot. We had bacteria that would kill us back when we didn't have antibiotics. Once we had antibiotics though, we treated them as a super weapon and we started attacking the bacteria with it. After some time, we stopped imagining the bacteria as something that would kill us, because we would always think that, oh my god, there's a bacteria infection, take an antibiotic. It got to the point where we started taking antibiotics for things as small as a cough, and right after that, bacteria started developing immunity, because bacteria are living things, they evolve. They started developing immunity towards our antibiotics by making pumps on their skin, which will pump the antibiotic antibodies out before they can do any serious damage to the actual bacteria. By doing this, we made super bugs. This is where the phages come in. So we had an enemy, we used a super weapon against it. The enemy got resistant to the super weapon, but doing so, it lost its inherent resistance to phages. After this, we use the phages' properties to trap the bacteria in a catch-22, where they choose one bad option or the other. So they either make up a resistance to phages and lose their thing to antibiotics, or they get one to antibiotics and lose their thing to phages. Either way, if we put both of them together, then it's almost impossible for the bacteria to survive. Even if they find a way to become resistant to either one, then the other one will still manage to destroy them. Thus, it's a catch-22. Phages, by the way, are an incredibly specialized force. You can think of antibiotics as a carpet bomb, where you have a bunch of good bacteria and a bunch of bad bacteria. The antibiotic will be a nuclear bomb that destroys everything. What the phages do, so basically, think about it like this. If antibiotics are a nuclear weapon, these are a nuclear guided warhead. They will only go to the things that they are programmed to destroy, and they will destroy them. They're very specialized, and there is one or two species of phage for every single species of bacteria on Earth, which is a very, very, very large number, and every single one of them has the capability to wipe bacteria off the face of the Earth. Last fun fact about phages. Phages destroy approximately 40% of the entire ocean's bacteria every single day. The bacteria multiply, which is why they don't insanely like increase in numbers, but they don't go down either because they multiply. But just think about the numbers. All the bacteria in the ocean, and almost half are being destroyed every single day. What does that tell you about phages? They're powerful. So the last controversial topic is genetic engineering ethical? There are people in this world who would use genetic engineering to their benefits. Luckily for us, most people are good and they would rather want everyone to be enhanced and also everyone to build up an immunity to bad diseases. But there is a question of whether or not genetic engineering is ethical for a few reasons. One, it may not be available to everyone. You can find two regions in this world. One region, people are taking way too many antibiotics and have way too much access to healthcare, more than they need. And on the other parts of the world, they don't have access to anything. People are dying in drugs. nose while other people are taking antibiotics for a cough. People are worried that the same thing will happen in genetic engineering, that all the people from rich families will just pay a ton of money because they're rich, and they will have their children become geniuses, have super strength, or all kinds of very good things. And people are worried that those in poor classes will not be have access to these things. This is why people think that genetic engineering may not be an ethical option in today's world. My personal opinion is that genetic engineering is worth it as long as we make sure everyone can get it. And basically, I hope you enjoyed my presentation. If you did, always remember to like, subscribe, and share my videos. Also, like I mentioned earlier, remember to go check out the Human Genome and Genetics video earlier. Thank you!